Hello everyone, I welcome all of you to today's session. Myself, I am Santosh, lecturer in Electronics and Communication Engineering Department, Government Polytechnic, Karkala. So first I would like to thank my colleagues, Vanita Madam and Omkarappa Sir, because they have covered fundamentals of ARM instructions, barrel shifter, classification of instruction. Until now you have studied branch instructions. So in this session, we are going to study load store instructions and different types of load store instructions, the various load store single register transfer instruction, and what are the different addressing mode supporting to load store instructions. And I will explain each instruction with an example. At the end of this section, you will be having MCQ, multiple choice questions. So in ARM controller, there is no move instruction to transfer data from memory to register and register to memory. So we have move instruction that can be used to transfer register to register only. So it is not possible to transfer data from memory to register and register to memory using move instruction. For this purpose, we have load store instructions. So load store instruction transfer data between memory and processor register. ARM has three sets of instruction which interact with main memory. So these are single register transfer, multiple register transfer, and swap instruction. So before going to the direct topic, I will first explain few basic concepts which are required during the understanding of these instruction. So first, understand what is mean by bit. So in digital, we always represent a number or some data with the help of zeros and ones. So zeros and ones. So we are having two bits, zero and one. So if we combine eight such bits, then we get 1 byte of data. So 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. So 1 byte. So equal to 8 bits. So if we combine 16 bits, then we get half word. So if we come, the collection of 16 bits are called half word. So if we collect 32 bits, then we call it as word. So most of the registers in ARM controller are 32 bits. So almost all register are 32 bits. So we can say they are having capacity to store 1 word information. So byte is nothing but 8 bits. Half word is nothing but 16 bits or 2 bytes, and word is nothing but 32 bits or 4 bytes. So in this session, we are going to study single register transfer load store instruction, which are nothing but LDR and STR. So first of all, we'll study what is mean by load and store operation. So ARM uses load store model for memory access, which means that only load store LDR and STR instruction can access memory. Load and store single register instruction can transfer 32 bit word or a half word, 16 bit half word, or a 8 bit byte between memory and register. So this is syntax. So LDR stands for load register, LD stands for load, R means register, load register. Load register means the transfer of data from memory to register. So whereas in STR stands for store register, the data transfer from register to memory. So this is the condition, this is optional. So byte, SB means signed byte, H means offered, SH means signed offered, and it supports different addressing modes. So now look into the various load store single register transfer instructions are. So these are the different load store instructions. So first one is the LDR. So there is no suffix after LDR. So this is load word into a register. So word means 32 bit. So it will load word 32 bit data from memory to register. LDRH. So H means off word. So load off word into a register. So off word means 16 bit data. So 16 bit data from memory will move to register. So LDRB, load byte into a register. So byte, B means byte. So from memory 8 bit data is moved to register. LDRSH, load signed off word into a register. So SH means signed off word. So this is also 16 bit data that signed. So I will explain it later. So here also the 16 bit data will move from memory to register, that is the sign number. So next one is the LDRSP, load signed byte. So 8 bit data. So 8 bit data, that is the sign extended, that 8 bit data will move from memory to register. So these five are the load instruction. So load word, load off word, load byte, load signed off word, load signed byte. Then next is the STR. So there is no suffix here. So STR means store word from a register. So see the direction. So in load memory to register, in store register to memory. So load word. So from register 32 bit data is moved to memory. So in STRH, off word, store off word from a register. So from register 16 bit data or off word move to or copy to memory address. Last one is the STRB. So store byte from a register. So in this case, a byte from register is moved to memory location. Byte and off word loads can be automatically zero extended or sign extended as they are loaded. So the important thing is all register in ARM are 32 bits wide. So if we take example of R10 register, so consider R10 register. R10 register. So the R10 register can store 32 bits of data, but if we load 16 bit data or 8 bit data from the memory, then what will happen to remaining bits of this particular register? So for that purpose, we are having this zero extended or sign extended operation. So what is mean by zero extended or sign extended? In sign extended operation, increasing the number of bits of a binary number while preserving the number sign, whether it is positive number or negative number, that preserve the sign of that number and value. For example, if you take one number, so take one number 1000001. So here, so this is the MSB bit. So basically, MSB bit represent sign of that particular number, and remaining bit represent magnitude. So this is the 8 bit data, right? This is the 8 bit data. If we load this 8 bit data into the R10 register of ARM, then we must have to convert this particular data into 32 bit, because R10 is a 32 bit wide. So we have to preserve the sign of this particular number. So then what we do? The MSB bit, as we know, always represent sign of that particular number. So if it is MSB bit is 1, that indicates the negative number. If the MSB bit is 0, that indicates the positive number. So we put 11111 in the remaining bits of the R10 register. So 11111111. So So this MSVBT is extended so that sign of this particular number should be preserved. So this is done by appending digits to the most significant side of a number. So in zero extended, all the remaining bits are filled with the zero. Suppose if the year in the sign extended, if the MSVBT is zero, then the remaining bits should be zero, filled with the zero. If MSVBT is one, negative number, the remaining bits filled with 111. If the MSVBT is zero, the remaining bits filled with the 000. But whereas in zero extended, all the remaining bits are filled with the zero. So whereas in sign extended, the depending upon the MSV bit, the remaining bits will be filled. So depending on the 1, so if it is MSV bit 1, remaining bits will be filled with 1. If it is MSV bit is 0, the remaining bits will be filled with 0. Then what are the different addressing mode supporting again load store instruction? The first one is the register indirect. So LDR R0, in square bracket R1. So R0 is the destination register, R1 is also register, but here R1 is used to hold the address of the memory. So that is represented by square bracket. The square bracket means that content hold the address. The memory address is specified in register R1. So that R1 register contains the memory address instead of data. This is the register indirect. See here, that memory to register will move. The memory address is held by register R1. So next one is the immediate offset. So LDR R0, within square bracket R1, #4. So this is the immediate data, which is, it is called offset 4. So this offset is added to base register R1 and get the memory address. So here the effective address is calculated. It is a combination of base register and the immediate value, offset value. The content of R1 plus 4 will be added. From that memory location, a word from that memory location will move to R0. So next is the register operation. So LDR R0, within the square bracket R1, -R2. That negative sign indicates that it performs the arithmetic operation. So here in the previous case, the effective address is calculated by content of R1 and immediate value, offset value. But here, the effective address is calculated using the two register R1 and R2. But here, there is a negative sign. The effective address is R1 minus R2. The content of R1 is subtracted. So content of R2, it is subtracted from the R1. So that is the effective address. From that memory location, a word will move to register. Last one is the scaled. So LDR R0, within square bracket R1, R2, LSL #2. So LSL is the barrel shifter operation, logically shift left by 2 times. The content of R2, which is logically left shift by 2. So logically left shift by 2 means, logically left shift by 2 means it will multiply R2 by 4. So if you perform one time logical left shift operation, it is multiplied by 2, 2 times multiplied by 4, 3 times multiplied by 8. So here R2 into 4, that resultant will added with the R1, that is the final resultant is the effective address. From that memory location, a word is moving to R0. The address is calculated using the base register and a barrel shift operation. So there are some other addressing mode methods, that is the index method. There are 3 types here: pre-index addressing mode and post-index addressing mode. Pre-index with write back and pre-index. So in the first one, pre-index with write back. So pre means before. So before load or store, effective address is calculated. Effective address is calculated, is a, how it will calculate? Here the base register plus offset. Base register plus offset. R1 is the base register and #4 is the offset. The content of R1 plus 4. So that is the effective address. So from that memory location, data will move to register. So here there is a symbol. explanation symbol. So it indicates that write back. So address, write back. So the explanation symbol indicates that the instruction writes the calculated address back to the base register address. Base register address here R1. So after the execution of LDR, so content of R1 plus 4, that resultant will be updated to R1. So whereas in pre-index, here it is not updated. The effective address is calculated the same way as in the pre-index with write back, but after the execution, that updated address is not reflected back to R1. So here the R1 content is unchanged. The effective address R1 plus 4, from that memory location data will move to R0, but R1 content is unchanged. Memory address is unchanged. It won't update the end address. Whereas in post-index addressing mode, so only the register holds the effective address. So you can see here within the square bracket only register. In pre-index, so within square bracket along with the base register may be immediate offset value or another register or logical shift operator. Whereas in post-index addressing mode, the only within the square bracket, only the base register, after that there may be immediate offset value or register or barrel shift operation. Now we will study the basic operation of load and store instruction with example. So consider here LDR R0 comma within square bracket R1. Here LDR means there is no suffix after LDR. So the LDR means load word. So load word, word means 32 bit data from memory to register. So R0 is the destination register, where R1 is hold the address of the memory. So that is the base register. So consider an example, R0 contains 000 before execution, R1 contains address, that is the 4. So here the R1 is pointing to memory location 4. So in that memory location, the data is 11, in memory location 5, 22, in memory location 6, 33, in memory location 7, 44. See, the word, word means 32 bit data. So if you consider memory, irrespective of the size of the memory, so each location can store, we can store only 1 byte of data. So irrespective of the size of the memory, so in each location we can store 1 byte of data. Suppose if you want to store 4 bytes, so we require 4 locations. If you want to store half word, it requires 2 locations. If you want to store 1 byte, so 1 location is enough. So here for the word, 4 locations are required. So we need to specify only the starting address. The ARM controller will automatically increment by 1. So and then it will get the next data also. So 4, 5, 6, 7. For the word, the starting address is 4. So 4 memory locations are 4, 5, 6, 7. So from memory to register, see R0. So from memory location 4, 5, 6, the data from lower address to lower byte and higher address to higher byte. So this is the little endian format. The 4, this is the lower byte, so this is the higher byte, right? So from the lower address, it will store to lower byte here. From the higher address, it will store to higher byte of the register. So here, all 4 bytes is copied to register. So that is the load word, 32 bit data. So in this example, consider LDRH. So LDRH means load half word. So load means memory to register, but H means half word, 16 bit data from memory to register. See here, so the 16 bit data, so 0 to 15. In R0, 0 to 15, that 16 bit data will move. But remaining bits, remaining 16 bits, 16 to 31, this is the 0 extended. Since R0 is a 32 bit register, so we are moving only the half word data, so 16 bit data, so the remaining 16 bits is filled with the 0. So consider an example, R0 contains 000 and address R1, register R1 contains the starting base address 04. Again, I will take the same example, 4, 5, 6, 7 location, the data are 11, 12, 22, 33, 44. So here, the R1 is pointing to location 0004. So load off word. Load means memory to register, only load the off word. Off word means 16 bit, so only two locations are enough. From two locations, the data will move to register. So lower byte, higher byte. For remaining 16 bits, that is the bit number 16 to 31, zeros are appended. So zero extended bits. So see the difference, LDR and LDRH. So next consider LDRB. So here, again load. Load means memory to register, but B means byte. So only 8-bit data from memory to register. So 8-bit data means 0 to 7. So 0 to 7, the 8-bit data will move to 0 to 7 position. The remaining 24 bits from 8 to 31 filled with 0. So see an example. So before execution, so let us consider. The same example, so same data, so R0 contains 0000, R1 contains the 04, that is the starting address, the base pointer address. So now load B, LDRB, so load byte from memory. So memory to register, only one byte of data is copied and remaining bits append with the 024 bits. So again, since R0 is a 32-bit register, but we are moving only the 1 byte of data from memory, so remaining 3 bytes appended with 0. So this is byte movement. So next consider LDRSH. So LDRSH, R0, comma within square bracket R1. So again LDR, so load, so from memory to register. Data will move from memory to register, only the off word, 16 bit data. So similar to LDRH. So 0 to 15, only 16 bit data will move. For remaining bits, most significant bit, that is the MSB bit, will move. So if it MSB bit is 1, then all 16 bits will be 1. If MSB bit is 0, all 16 remaining 16 bit will be 0. So consider this example. So before execution, so same data, so R0 contains 000, R1 contains 4, the 4 memory location. So here R1 is pointing to, so 0004. So load off word. So first coming to off word. Off word means 16 bit data. So two locations are enough. So only 2 bytes is moved to register, but the remaining bits, now it's depending on the MSB bit. So here 2 means 0010. Again 2 means 0010. 1 means 0001. 0001. So this is LSB, this is MSB. Now the MSB bit is 0. That is the positive number. So that 0 will extend to remaining 16 bits. So that's why here it is zeros are appended, because MSB bit is 0. So sign extended bit, the sign, that is the positive number. So when it converted to 32 bit, so now also this is MSB bit is 0. Now also it preserves the sign and value. So next consider LDRSP. So LDR byte, so signed byte. So again from memory to register, only 8 bit of data will move to register. So 0 to 7, the remaining bits, bit 8 to 31, so MSB bit will be moved. If the MSB bit is 0, 0 will move. If MSB bit is 1, the remaining 24 bits will with the 1. So consider this example, the same data. So before execution, R0 is equal to 0, R1 is equal to 4. the pointer register R1 is pointing to memory location 4. In that location 88 is present. So LDRSP, load signed byte. So only one byte from memory it is moved to register. So okay, 88. For remaining bits here it is FFF. Why it is FFF? See, 88 means 1000 1000. See here, the MSC bit is 1, so that 1 will copy to remaining bits. So 1 1 1, so the remaining bits will be 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1. So 1 1 1 1 means FFFF. So remaining 24 bits will be FFF. Since so now also the MSV, after converting it to 32 bit, so now also MSV bit is 1, that indicates this is the negative number which reserve its sign and the value. So next, consider store. What is the meaning by store? Store mean register to memory. So see the direction, from register to memory. So store means word 32 bit data. So 32 bit data from register to memory location. So consider before execution, R0 contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and R1 contains memory address 0004. So before execution, some data in memory. So after execution, see, in the previous case, the data is moving from memory to register, but in this case here, from register to memory. So again, as I told, so this is the word, so it requires 4 memory location. So the starting address is 0004, so it requires 4 memory location, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So the lower byte will move to lower address, higher byte is moved to higher address. So next, higher address. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 78 is here, 56 in 5th location, 34 in 6th location, and 12 in the 7th location. So here, direction from register to memory. So next example is STRH. So store offered. So here also, register to memory. So offered 16 bit data from register to memory. So here I have used pre-index addressing mode. So R1 plus comma hash 2. So offset value is 2. So here the effective address is calculated before the store. So R1 plus R2. So let us consider an example. So before execution, R0 contains 0x123456789. R1 contains the address 4. But the before execution, R1 hash 2, see here, R1 plus 2, the content of R1 is 0004, plus 2 means 0006. So that is the effective address. From that memory location, content of R0 will move. See, R0 is a 32 bit, but we are moving only the offered. So only the 2 bytes, so 16 bit. So lower byte to lower memory address and higher byte to higher memory location. So only the offered 2 bytes. So next one is the STRB. So store byte means again register to memory, only a byte of data from register to memory. So here also I am using the same addressing mode, pre-index addressing mode, R1 comma hash 2. This is the base register R1 and offset value is 2. The effective address is calculated before, pre means before. So before store, the effective address is calculated R1 plus R2. So let us consider an example. So before execution, R0 contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So R1 contains the memory address 4. See here, same. The effective address is, it's a combination of R1 plus 2. So R1 content is 4 plus 2 means 6. So this is the effective address. Now, to this address, a byte of data from register will move. So only a byte, so lower byte to memory location. One byte of data is moved to memory location. So store byte. So in this session we have discussed so different load store instruction. What is the mean by load store architecture, load store operation, and different addressing modes supported to load store instruction. So let's look into some few multiple choice question. So take a pen and paper. So just note down the question number and write the answer option A, B, C, or D. So at the end of this session, so you assessment by yourself. The first question is ARM processor don't support byte addressability. So option A is true, B is false. The ARM processor don't support byte addressability. The answer is false. So because it support, so here it don't support. Actually ARM processor supports the byte addressability. We can move or transfer, copy byte or off word or word. So just now we have discussed we can move byte operations also. So it supports the byte addressability. So for this question, answer is false. The ARM processor don't support byte addressability. This is the wrong statement. This is the false. So next question. So each instruction in ARM machine is encoded into dash word. So each instruction in ARM machine is encoded into dash word. So A 2 byte, B 3 byte, C 4 byte, and D 8 byte. So the answer is 4 byte. So each instruction is encoded into 32 bit word. So 32 bit word is nothing but 4 bytes. So answer is C, 4 bytes. So next question is, all instructions in ARM are conditionally executed. So A true, B false. So all instruction in ARM are conditionally executed. Yes, it is true. So you have, I think you have observed in all instruction, so LDR, after that I have put in flower bracket COND, that is the condition. So like condition means EQ, equate, NE not equal. So there is a table at the beginning of this unit. So all instruction ARM are conditionally executed. That is not mandatory, that is optional, but all instruction can be executed conditionally. So this is the true. So next instruction is, sorry, next question is, the addressing mode where the EA, EA means effective address of the operand, is the content of RN dash. So A pre-indexed mode, B pre-indexed with write back mode, C post-indexed mode, and D none of the mentioned. The addressing mode where the effective address of the operand is the contents of RN. So it is post-indexed. So in post-index, the content of the base register itself is the effective address. So next question, the effective address of the instruction written in post-indexed mode, LDR R3, within square bracket RN, hash 6, is effective address is equal to RN, effective address is RN plus 6, effective address is RN plus RN, effective address is 6. The answer is A. So effective address is equal to RN. See, in the previous question I told, in post index mode the effective address is base register itself. In the square bracket, the only the base register will be present. The immediate value or offset value or register or barrel shift or operation after the square bracket. So whereas in pre-index mode, so within the square bracket combination of both, but in post index within square bracket only the base register will be presented. That is the effective address in post indexed addressing mode. So next is the effective address of the instruction written in pre indexed mode, LDR R3, within square bracket RN, hash 6, is effective address is RN, B effective address is RN plus 6, effective address is equal to RN plus RN, effective address is equal to 6. So for this question, answer is B. So here within the square bracket, so RN base register plus 6 offset value. So both pre means before load, the effective address will be calculated using RN and opposite. The effective address is equal to Rn plus 6. So next question is LDRSH RD comma within square bracket R1. Which of the following instruction is true? So RD. So load means, so here see the direction, 32 bit data is moved to RD, here sign extended 16 bit data is moved to RD, see here sign extended 8 bit data is moved to RD, see here from register RD to memory 16 bit to memory address. For this question answer is V. See here LDR means load, load means memory to register. So here SH, H means offered, but here SH, signed, so sign extended, so depending on the MSB bit, right? So 16 bit data from memory will move to RD with sign extension, so it will preserve the sign of that number. So next question is, the instruction LDR, R0, within square bracket R1, #4, so after that there is an explanation symbol, so is an example of dash addressing mode. A pre-index, B post-index, C pre-index with write-back, all of the above. So the answer is C, pre-index with write-back. So whenever we use explanation symbol, so after this is a pre-index. Pre-index means before the execution, it will calculate the effective address. So it is a combination of base register plus offset value R1 plus 4. So when we put explanation symbols after the load, it will update the effective address to R1. If explanation symbol is not present, then R1 is unchanged. So since explanation symbol is present, so after the execution of LDR, so it will update the R1. So pre-index with write back. So next question is LDR stands for load double register, B load register, C load multiple register, D none of the above. So LDR means load register. So option B is the right answer, load register. And last question is STRB stands for A store bit from a register, B load byte from a register, C store byte from a register, D all of the above. So STRB means store byte from a register. So store, STR means store, B means byte, not bit, right? This is not a load instruction, it is a store instruction. So store byte from a register. So at the end of this question, so you assessment by yourself and you can see your result. So okay, I will end today's session now. So in the next session, I am going to discuss with you all. So today we have discussed single register transfer. So next session, I am going to discuss with you all multiple register transfer, load and store instructions, LDM and STM instructions. Thank you all.